my favourite time of the year. I mean, I love any occasion, any festive occasions, events, so, but Christmas is definitely the best one. It's right up there.
I think we all love buying presents for people, and yes. I just like really spending time with family around that time as well.
I think I must have been about 12, and I've, you know, always wanted to be a singer. And my mum bought me a PA system, and that was like the best thing. I had proper mic.
I had that as well.
Yeah, speakers, I got the karaoke machine,
the
kids
thing.
One.
Yeah. And you just couldn't get me off it. I love getting presents that I think someone's going to love. I got my sister a laptop last year, and I think she was really surprised because she lived with me in London and always used to use mine. And then Christmas morning, I bought her a nice little black Apple Mac, and she was really shocked at that. So that was nice to see her really pleased and downloading all the pictures onto it and stuff.
I never do anything in a day, but I just love like saving it behind the counter and saying, oh yeah, I'll be back. And I know I'm gonna really go overboard this year.
I have to put flat shoes on, like I have the whole day to do it, and there's a few good days, and I've learned not to take cabs. I need to take my car so I can go back and store the bags in the booths. Because otherwise you can't get around the shops with all the presents, but I just love it. I love going in the shops and the Christmas music playing and then wrapping them all. I make more wine and wrap all the presents with Christmas music.
I'm a bit of a late one, to be honest. I normally, even though I never planned to do it like this, I probably get it about 4 days before Christmas, up to a week. It always ends up that I'm quite late. I need about 4 days, really.
You know when you're doing your shopping, and then there's a music playing, the Christmas music. I love that.
Is that the R&B version?
I probably spend the most on my mum and my brother. It's so weird because when you start shopping, there's always something that I see for myself as well.
I'm the same.
So you're buying for yourself and you're buying for everyone else.
So bad. Or you get them the same top and you buy yourself the same thing.
Well, yeah, I buy people things that I think I'd like sometimes, which is really bad.
Yeah.
But I think I probably spend the most money on my mum, sister and my boyfriend. You put everyone's name in a hat.
Yeah.
So like say Paul, Colin, everyone who we work with.
Oh!
Take the name out and you've got to buy the present
for that person.
Yeah. But when they get given it, they don't know who it's from. They just have their present and then they open it and they kind of got to guess who's got from the present.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, I like that.
I always put a Christmas album on and make more wine to put me tree up.
We go to church in the morning and then we have to, my mum makes breakfast, and she makes the biggest breakfast. We watch Christmas movies, because around that time there's always good stuff on TV, like all the old movies and stuff, and just relax.
Every Christmas morning we have chocolates and champagne for breakfast, and then we always go to my nan's house, and then we always go to my other nan's, and then we always go to the pub, and then we always have dinner, and then we go home. As a kid, every Christmas Eve, my mum used to take us to my Auntie Diane's. Hers was the only present we could open, because every year she used to get us new pyjamas and slippers. And we were allowed to wear them on Christmas Eve, so we used to get them. We'd always do a picture in front of the tree in our rollers and new pyjamas and like Mickey Mouse slippers.
Aww.
And then we'd go off to bed, and then I'd wake up about 3 a.m. with teeth rattling with excitement.
Yeah, can never remember that one thing, can never get to sleep. Ever.
I just used to wake up so early.
Yeah, and really up 6 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah. Go, he's been.
Yeah. A nice bath,
nice
actually.
Bath.
Yeah. Soak yourself in there.
Sort
out your nails while you're in there.
One thing,
just cut the cuticles.
Yeah, I love the whole beauty.
Yeah.
Full on. But one thing I love about getting ready is the clothes that you wear, because the weather's really cold outside. And I love the fact that you can dress up a little bit more.
I like to plan the outfit before I take the bath.
Yes.
So you know what
you're wearing.
An
idea of what you're wearing.
And then you know what way you're going to go for makeup. And one thing I will say is that we were given by Boots, and I don't know if you've tried it in a Boots bag, No. 7 leg oil.
Yes, exactly what I was going to say.
And I had a proper bubble bath the other day, and used it on my legs, and I really like to sort of just use it everywhere because it's really nice.
Yeah.
So that is something that is going to be going in stockings this year.
A Christmas red lipstick,
yeah,
and glitter.
And eyeliner, they're just the ticks.
Yeah.
The simple sort of classic
look. I've never
look.
Tried a red lip around Christmas, ever.
That's when it comes out.
Yeah.
Red lip.
And you always have sparkly nail varnish.
Well, I have red lips and a tick. Or a tick of sparkly eyeliner. I think you can wear sparkle at Christmas.
Yeah. You can see everyone bring out sparkle at Christmas.
I think my favourite item at the moment, and I think it's one of them else as well, is Dior do like a almost like a shimmer brick, and it's great.
Oh, yeah.
And you can dust it on the cheeks, on your nose, your body, and it's really, really nice.
It gives you a really nice sort of.
And then I use mine as an eyeshadow as well.
Yeah, and like just under the eyebrow as
well.
Yeah,
it's really good.
Yeah.
Brow.
A nice brow is always really nice.
Well, but in either a fry up or a Sunday roast, if you also have
get used to it, man. You wear them constantly, so I don't know how you do that.
I wear heels even when I don't have to.
Do you naturally tiptoe when you're at home? Like,
well,
just because you're not used to it?
Until I moved in to my new place with my boyfriend, I still used to, not for any reason, I'd just forget to take my heels off when I got home. So I'd be cleaning up in heels.
The average person would run home to get them off.
And cooking heels and everything. So I've started to wear flats at home, but any other time I do wear heels, then I'm...